हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज योर इंग्लिश ग्रेड कॉम्पिटिटिव एयर बुलेटिन फॉर ग्रामर लेसन दैट इज सब्जेक्ट वर्ब एंड इट मींस कॉन्वर्ट व्हाट टू बाय कॉन्वर्ट कॉन्वर्ट मींस एग्रीमेंट कॉन्वर्ट मींस एग्रीमेंट मींस अग्री अग्रीमेंट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ द ग्रामर व्हिच हेल्प्स यू टू सॉल्व मेनी क्वेश्चंस व्हिच कम इन बोर्ड एग्जाम एज अ करेक्शन ओमिशन और मे बी ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स आल्सो there from this topic. And if we think about the spoken English, this lesson is very, very important because subject verb agreement, you know better that the element of the sentence are subject and verb. Without these two elements, we can't make complete sentence or we can't make meaningful sentence because subject and verb both are very very important. When you are at the very basic elementary level of your education, that time you have learned subject and verb. Okay, I speak, I run, I dance. These particular sentences you might have learned in your preschool or when you were in first and second standard. So now we are going to learn it very very proper way, okay? Because many times we see people or person speaks in wrong way. Because in the sentence there should be agreement of the subject to the verb. If it is not there, then you are not speaking correctly. Okay? So you know that the verb will ever when you are in first standard or when you fourth standard, singular subject and plural subject. First person singular, second person singular, third person singular, then your first person plural, second person plural, and third person plural. That you have learned. You see that first person singular is R, second first person plural is B, second person singular you, and second person plural you, third person singular. Third person plural, they, that we have learned, and we have saw that we have taken one of the verb and we have used this verb for all the subjects. So what exactly you have learned? One very basic rule of this lesson, that is subject verb agreement, that is subject must agree with the verb, then only the sentence which we will utter, which we will write, will be correct. Otherwise means at any condition subject must with the verb, then only the sentence is correct. So first one you are going to learn, maybe rules are there that you are going to learn. First rule, if subject is singular, verb must be singular. Okay, if subject is singular, verb must be singular. I am a boy. You can understand here. So I means singular. So here am, it is also singular verb. If I will use here, I am a boy. Will be a meaningful sentence? Not at all. It is not at all meaningful sentence. So I is the subject and is the verb. So here in this sentence, I agrees with M. So subject is singular, verb also singular. If it is there, then only we can say it is a meaningful or correct sentence. What is the second rule? If subject is plural, verb must be plural. First rule was if subject is singular, in number, verb must be singular. Second rule is that if subject is plural, you, then verb must be plural. You are students of class 10. So here, subject agrees with verb. Subject is plural and verb also plural. Okay, so what we have learned? When, first rule is that when subject is singular, we have to use singular verb. If subject is plural, we have to use plural verb. This third rule, if two subjects are connected by an, if two singular subjects are connected by an, then we have to use plural verb. For example, Raman and Suman are members of people. Means Raman is it becomes plural verb, plural subject. Okay, so we have to use here R is a plural verb. So we have taken first rule, that was if subject is singular, verb must be singular. Second rule was that if subject is plural, verb must be plural. And then last one we have learned, if two subjects are connected by an, then we have to use plural verb. Okay, so these are the three rules which we have learned. Now fourth rule, if two singular subjects connected by either or neither nor, we have to take singular verb. For example, either or neither nor, I will do either this or that. So I will do, okay, or he does neither that nor this. Okay, so here also we have taken neither nor, either or. In the subject, there are words like neither nor, either or. We have to use singular verb. He does not well either in mathematics or in English. Okay, does in the subject. He does not do well either in mathematics or in English. So we have learned here either or neither nor. So when these two words are there in sentence, either or neither nor, we have to use singular verb. Okay, for example, my aunt or my uncle is arriving today. My aunt or uncle is arriving today. Or neither John nor Cameron is available tonight. Neither John nor Cameron is available tonight. So here in the both sentence, what we have taken? Construction where either or neither nor, we have taken singular verb. Then either Kaina or Casey is helping today. Either Kaina or Lazy is helping today. So here, so in the connecting sentence, if there is either or neither nor construction, then we have to use that singular verb. Today we are going to learn last rule of this. Today's last rule of subject verb agreement. That is, if you know some subject look like plural, but they are singular, they will take singular verb. For the physics, no. Whenever any singular verb, any subject or any noun, text, any subject like S or ES, we feel that it is a plural. For example, mathematics is singular, but we feel that it is a plural. So mathematics, the subject of mathematics, physics, gymnastics. Okay, so like these subjects are there, electronics, so which looks like plural, but they are singular. This kind of noun, this kind of subject, text, always singular verb. So these five rules we have learned today. First one, we are going to learn if we have learned that if some subject is singular, we have to use singular verb. Second, if subject is plural, we have to use plural verb. Third, two subjects or two singular subjects connected by an, then we have to use plural verb. Why? Because Ram and Suman. So by counting these two singular subjects becomes plural. So it becomes, or we have to use the plural verb. Then third one, neither nor or either or, that also we have learned. If in the sentence, there is construction of neither nor or either or, we have to use singular verb. Example, neither he nor she Clericals. Okay, neither nor, either or. Suppose these words are there in the sentence, how to use singular verb. And last one, some subjects look like plural, but they are actually singular, such as physics, mathematics, okay, many electronics. Okay, so these subjects, these nouns look like plural, but they are singular. So we have to use singular verb. So all these five rules which we have seen today, which we have learned today, in that one basic thing, those all rules have told, if subject is singular, we have to use singular verb. And if subject is plural, we have to use singular plural verb. So just see, if subject is singular, we have to use singular verb. If subject is plural, we have to use plural verb. Then neither nor, either or, then we have to use the singular verb. And last one, we have learned, that is, some subjects look like plural, but they are actually singular. So we have to use, in such cases, we have to use singular verb. So as I told you, this lesson is very, very important in your exam perspective, that it will enable you to solve the questions of error correction, omission, or fill in the blank. So this time, we have to think, we have to give one khanda, that is, if subject is singular, then we have to use singular verb. If subject is plural, we have to use plural verb. So subject must agree with the verb. Then only we can make a meaningful sentence. So number, as well, I told you, I, you, he, she, these are the singular subjects, and we, you, they, these are the plural subjects. Okay. So I think you might have understood these five words, which are very simple, in today's lecture. So thank you very much. Just write down your own notes of these five rules, and then write down five more examples.